Welcome. In this video, I am going to discuss how to delete a record from binary file. That is, you are going to delete a record from binary file, binary file deletion. See the question, create a binary file student with roll number, name and age. Delete all the students' details whose age is more than 20. So you have to create a binary file student which consists of roll number, name and age, and you have to delete all the records, all the students' details whose age is more than 20. See the procedure for deletion. So first you have to read the content from the binary file. First you have to create the binary file, and second step you are reading the content from the binary file and check the condition. Your condition is age more than 20. If the condition is not satisfied, then you are copying that record into another file. That means if age is less than 20, you are copying the record into a new file. That procedure will be repeated till the end of file is reached. And after that, you are removing the old file and you are renaming the new file as the old one. This is the procedure for binary file deletion. Read the content, check the condition. If the condition is not satisfied, you are copying into a new file and you are removing the old file and you are renaming the new file as old one. Now I'll do that in the Python screen. See that already create function is there, or create method is there, and here, yes, create method, total number of students is A, accepted, roll number, name and age accepted, and it is added to the list. After that you copy that dump into the file. That means the nested list is written into the file. That creation part is over. Next, deletion part is started. I am going to open. The first thing you have to read from the file. So the file is opened in read mode, and I am using the load method to read from the file. So the entire content now present in the variable Q. That much I written over there. And one by one record I am going to extract from the variable Q. So for K in Q. So that means you are extracting record by record. The first record, it will be available in the variable K when the first time for loop is executed. So one by one records are extracted and stored in the variable K. And we have to check whether the age is greater. The age means that is the second attribute, 0, 1, 2. So subscript will be 2. So age is greater than 20. K greater than 2. Then that means age greater than 2. So if age greater than 2, then you have to delete. Otherwise you have to copy into a new file. So K of 2 less than or equal to 20. I am going to copy into a new file. So new file, first step you have to open the new file. P2 equal to open. My new file name is stud2.dat. And I am opening that file in write mode, RB mode. You are writing into the file. So if the condition, here the condition is mentioned as age less than 20. We have to delete all the record whose age is greater than 20. If it is less than, I am copying into a new file. So p dot dump of, your variable name is K and your object name is p2. Yes, that procedure will be repeated till the end of the variable, end of the list Q is reached. And after that, I am going to close both the streams, p1.close, and at the same time it is closing p2 stream also closed. Both the streams are closed. Now all the records that satisfy this particular condition, if the age is less than 20, that records will be copied into stud2.dat. Now I am going to remove stud1.dat. There is a remove function is there, that will be there in the module. We studied the module OS in the last chapter, import OS. So that remove function is there in the module OS. So that is why I just imported that OS module over there. And here I am going to use that module OS dot remove of the first file. First file is stud1.dat. That is the first file. So which contain the entire whole records are will be there in variable stud1. That is removed. And next I am going to rename the new file stud2. So os dot rename of which file you want to rename, that you have to mention in the beginning, the as a first argument. So that means stud2.dat and comma, and that you have to rename as stud1.dat. So after the execution of this statement, the entire content of stud2 will be there in the variable stud1. Next, I am going to open again stud1 in read mode, and I am going to display the content on the screen. So to open in read mode, I am using p1 equal to open, my file is stud1.dat, and it is opening in r mode, rb mode, read mode. See, the difference is here. Here you are writing the content into your stud 2.dat as individual record or individual list. When you create the file here, it will be a nested list. That means the whole list you are writing into the file. But here, when you come across your delete function, you are writing into stud2. It is you are writing as an individual list. Individual records are writing into stud2. So when you read back from the stud2, same way you have to read it as an individual record, not as a nested list. Here I am going to read the content from stud2 or stud1. Now stud2 is changed as stud1. So I am going to read from stud1 as an individual record. So I am using the loop over there. While true, it must be repeated using the try except block. Try first record k equal to your pickle name is p dot load of object name is p1. So the first record that and that stored in the variable k. Now we are going to print that values k of 0, k of 1 and k of 2, right? Next I am going to use except block, except end of file error. All these things we already studied. And if you reach at the end of the file, you are breaking from the loop. So that procedure will be repeated. The only thing you are studying here, remove and rename. Remove will remove the file and rename will rename the existing file. So after this renaming, stud2 will be renamed as stud1. And from stud1, you are reading the content. You are reading the content as an individual record, individual list. And after each read operation, you are displaying that onto your screen. Now we can try out what's working or not. Del function. I am going to input the values. Total number of students I am going to give us 3. And now see that 3 records are entered here. Roll number 12, 67 and 18. There will be 2 records whose age is less than 20. And one record more than 20 is there. Check it. See here, these 2 records will be there in the new file, or that will be there in the stud1.dat. Now I'll show you the program. This is your del function opening both the file, original file and new file, reading the content from the original file, checking the condition. If the condition is mentioned over here is as less than 20, if the age is less than 20, you're copying into a new file. After that, you are removing the old one and renaming the new one. Next step, you are reading the content from the new file, and that is you are reading as an individual record, not as a nested list. Okay. Now, thank you, children.